mind, body health. It's lectured by Dr. Xin Lin. Dr. Xin Lin is a professor in UCI Department of Developmental and Cell Biology. Susan Samurai Center for Integrative Medicine. He's also director of lab for mind, body, signaling, and energy research at UCI. This series is presented by South Coast Chinese Cultural Association and Susan Samurai Center for Integrative Health at UC Irvine. It's sponsored and supported by Mount TJ Southern California Science Technology Association and by Legacy Fountain Angel. A brief background of Dr. Xin Lin. He is the founding director of Lab for Mind, Body, Signaling, and Energy Research at UC Irvine. He's a former member of U.S. National Advisory Council on Complementary Medicine and Integrative Health. He's also served on the editorial board for Journal of Chinese Medicine, the Journal of Alternative Complementary Medicine. He had in-house training of 15 years with Grandmaster Chen Zhenlei, which is Chen family village, the birthplace of Tai Chi. We have a series of healthy living. This is series number 2 and number 3. Series number 3 is Tai Chi with music for mind body health. There will be May 8th, session 4 on the subject of science based Tai Chi for muscle, bone, and cardiovascular health. And series 5 will be on June 12th. Sign-based Qigong for stretching to prevent pain and inflammation. So welcome, join us today, and hopefully you will join us for the rest of the series. And this whole series has been recorded on video and has been posted on the website of sccca.org. If you go on to the website, go to the bottom of this page, you click on the YouTube icon at the bottom, and you will see a series of video recording and Dr. Lin's previous series is also posted on it, and you're welcome to do that at your leisure, at your home, whenever you have time. So, without further ado, let's give hands to Dr. Xin Lin. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
I'm still recovering from a sore throat, so I will speak rather softly. If you can't hear me, it would be great. Let me see, how many of you are here for the first time that you have not come to any of the other ones? Okay. And the rest of you came to lecture 1 and 2, I think.
Yes.
So tonight's session is a little bit different in emphasis than the first two. The first two, I spoke for over an hour on lecture, and then
demonstration, okay, for the rest of the time. Tonight, I want to take the time to really teach you how to do these exercises. So that when you leave, you really know how to do it. So I will only speak for 20 minutes, and then the rest of the time, we will just learn the techniques and so forth. So, science-based Tai Chi, first of all, since there are people who are new here, I want to take a few minutes and explain a little bit about the type of Tai Chi that we will teach here. So, we talk about Tai Chi for health, not for fighting, self-defense. Harvard Medical School has it on their website. It says, you know, Tai Chi is often referred to as meditation in motion, but it might as well be called medication in motion because of all the evidence now coming out from randomized controlled trials that is potentially useful for treating anywhere from Parkinson's, fibromyalgia, arthritis, high blood pressure, diabetes, on and on and on. So what is Tai Chi? Tai Chi is a philosophical principle. It's pervasive in Chinese art, literature, music, and martial arts, and so forth. So you see, this is the Tai Chi symbol. If this is yang, white, this is yin, black. So from the yang comes the yin. From the yin comes the yang. Within the yang, there is yin. Within the yin, there is yang. Perfect harmony of yin and yang. Translated to Tai Chi Chuan, which is what we're going to do tonight, we can say it's a perfect harmony, balance of hard, yang, and soft movements, fast and slow movements, dynamic and steady. Within the hard comes the soft, from the soft comes the hard. Within the hard is soft, within the soft is hard. Perfect harmony. That's true Tai Chi. Now, if you somewhat puzzled, like what's Dr. Lin talking about? Tai Chi is about old people in the park, you know, doing this. Well, it's fast and slow. So, let me give you a quick review of the written history of Tai Chi. I don't mean Tai Chi depicted in martial arts movies and Wuxia Xiaoshuo. You know, novels, and no, this is the real history written down. Okay, Tai Chi did not come from. There's no evidence it comes from Zhang Sanfeng, and you know all that. That's just legends. For real, Tai Chi started in the Chen family village, Sanjiakou. As the Chen style Tai Chi, and it's recognized as something started by Han Wangting. Back in the 16th century, 15th century. And you see the yin and the yang and the harmony and so forth. That's 11 generations ago. When it gets to be the 6th generation ago, Chen Changqing was the grandmaster then, passed on each generation as the best guy, you know, Tang Wenren. He taught Chen Zhao Tai Chi to Yang Luchan, who's not from the Yang family, not the Chen family. He went to the Chen family and learned Tai Chi. And he started what we now know as Yang style Tai Chi. he took away all of the yang and ended up with only the yin. So what you probably see, you know, in the parks of people doing this is slow, soft. That's the yin, there's no yang here, okay? So this is the more recognizable, popular type of Tai Chi called Yang style Tai Chi. Now, of course, the Chen family continues until now it's the 11th generation, and Chen style Tai Chi is now headed by Grandmaster Chen Zhenwei, and I'm proud to have trained with him for 15 years now, many more years before I met him, actually. And Chen Xiaohuang, they are first cousins, they are co-holder of the Zhangmenren position. But you see, the Yang style, which is devoid now of the Yang, so Yin, gave rise to the Wu style, started by Wu Chuanyou. And Mr. Wu Yuxiang, okay, learned from the Yang style, also a little bit of the Chen style, but kept mostly the Yang style and started the Wu style. And that gave rise to also the Sun style. So right now it's recognized that there are five major styles of Tai Chi: Chen, the original style, Yang, the most more popular style, Wu, and Sun. So at this point, Chen style is the only one that has the complete yin and yang harmony. And all of these because of Yang Hu Chan, all these other styles has only the yin. And tonight, I'm going to emphasize the yin side of Chen style Tai Chi. And next month, I will teach you the yang side of Chen style Tai Chi and how they could mix together in a harmonized way. So this is like part one of two parts. I know what I'm talking about because not only did I train for 15 years with Grandmaster Chen Zhenwei in Chen style Tai Chi, I also had the great fortune to train with the grandsons of Yang Hu Chan, grandsons of Sun Wu Ting, grandsons of Wu, and so forth. So I actually trained in all five types as well. I will keep to the 20-minute mark, okay? So very quickly, review some of the points we talked about and add the latest stuff that I have not talked about. So Tai Chi, just like Qigong, is San Tiao He Yin, integration of three regulations. Regulation of the mind, body, and breathing. So in terms of the research and science behind all of this, so first we talk about regulating the mind. Tai Chi is supposed to give us deep rest, stress relief, mental concentration. Tai Chi has been specified as number one in most effective in stress relief, quantitatively measured as decreasing high blood pressure. This is a 2008 report from the United States Agency for Health Research Quality after reviewing 800 papers on meditative practices. You see Tai Chi is way on top as the most effective in stress relief, followed by Qigong, yoga, and all the yellow types are the ones that you kind of sit down to this, not very effective. And this is something I've shown you before. Some research we've done show that when we measure a person in a deep meditative state, like Tai Chi, or, you know, Zanzong, standing meditation, or sitting meditation, we can see that using this high-tech method called photon migration spectroscopy, that blood utilization of oxygen in the brain immediately goes down as you get to the meditative state. It goes down and down and down. You're in a deep, deep restful state. This is very important because this is proof that when you are deeply concentrated, you're not sleeping, deeply concentrating, you really don't use up much energy. You can really rest and concentrate at the same time. It is when you are, you know, thinking about 100 different things, trying to, you know, study or do some work, and radio and the TV is on and people in the background. It's like trying to do homework at Starbucks, you know. You use up a whole lot of energy, but not getting much done. Regulation of the breath. I've shown you this before, so very quickly. We show that using a multifunctional recording system, we see that when you breathe in and out and in and out, a deep, long breath. In, out, in, out, in, out, okay. We see waves of higher blood flow go through your body. And when you integrate all of these peaks, your blood circulation goes up like 50%. So when you go into this deep, restful, slow breathing of no more than 6 times a minute, this is the threshold. Normally you breathe at 12 times a minute. When you slow it down to 6 times a minute, you actually pump more blood throughout the body. Also, in this experiment with animals I've shown you before, when the cat, in this case, breathe deeper and deeper and deeper breaths, serotonin in the brain goes up from baseline to up and up. So deep breathing cycles could increase serotonin in the brain to put you in a better mood, certainly, but better, you know, digestion, resistance to pain, sleep better, all sorts of, improvement in body function. In our laboratory, we also show that deep breathing could really calm you down in a measurable way. We get subjects to sit in front of a TV and we show them horror movies or make them play very stressful video games. And you see, at rest, heart rate is at this level. Once you start playing these video games, heart rate jumps up. But when we tell these subjects to breathe slow and deep breath, the heart rate will come back down even while the game is going on. Blood pressure before, after the start of the game, and deep breathing. And these are not, you know, trained people. They have never done this before. We just tell them to breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, and the blood pressure measurably comes down. But finally, I have something new for you that you, no one has seen, because this paper just got published last week, as a matter of fact, March 2017. Scientists are making tremendous progress in trying to understand the things I talked about. We're not just talking about breathing and heart rate, we're now down to cells. So scientists at UCLA and Stanford have shown that, here's the whole brain, and, you know, the brain could receive stimulus in terms of smell, sight, hearing, okay? May put you in a stressful or relaxing condition. Now it's known that, this is not proportional, it's scaled, of course. Within the brain, this is the brain stem. within the brainstem, the scientists have isolated a part called the breathing pacemaker. It's a group of cells. And within the breathing pacemakers, the scientists have identified 64 different types of cells. So like, you know, the blue types and the red types and red and so forth. And they now can link, like this type of cells have to do with nervousness. Now this is done on animals, sniffing. When the mice are really nervous, they go okay, jittery like this. And when they knock out these cells, the mice are like they do meditation. No matter the how you scare them, you say, "Here comes the cat," nothing. Okay, oh, the cat, oh, nothing. Everything is as nice and calm. Okay, if they knock out these cells, they also identify these cells in the breathing pacemaker center. These cells have to do with sighing. It's like, ah, oh, like that. Okay, so when they knock out these cells, the mice could get really frustrated, but they don't go, oh. So now we could like pinpoint different groups of cells that are specific for different types of breathing, thinking, feeling, and behaving. And they're closing in on cells that have to do with slow, deep breathing that will calm people down. So by next year, I hope when I give another talk like this, I will be able to